Jai Hind students, today we are going to deal with chapter 15, our environment. In this chapter, we are going to read about the effect of adding waste to the environment. Human activities produce a lot of waste materials which are thrown or dumped into the environment. These waste result in water, air and soil pollution. And these wastes are basically of two types, biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. Biodegradable waste is the one which is actually decomposed by microorganisms present in soil into harmless products. This will include vegetable peels, fruit peels, pulses, cereals, cotton, jute, leather, paper, etc. And the other category of waste is of non-biodegradable waste, which mainly is the waste that is not decomposed by microorganisms. It remains as such in the soil. Example, polythene bags, plastics, synthetic fibers, glass, etc. Then next comes the ecosystem and its components. Ecosystem consists of all the living organisms in an area along with the non-living components and their interaction. Means it basically deals with living and non-living components present in the environment and their interaction. Ecosystem is also of two types, natural and artificial. Natural ecosystem will include forests, deserts, grasslands, mountains, where the ecosystems are managed by organisms themselves. And when we talk of artificial ecosystem, like gardens, parks, crop fields, aquarium, etc., they are actually requiring human interference and thus they come under artificial ecosystem category. Components of ecosystem. There are two major components which are present in ecosystem, biotic and abiotic. Biotic components include the living components like plants, animals, microorganisms. They consist of producers, consumers, and decomposers. And when we talk of producers, producers include basically all the green plants, which are called as autotrophs, which prepare their own food. When we talk of consumers, they are actually heterotrophs, which are basically dependent on producers for their food requirements directly or indirectly. Decomposers are the microorganisms which decompose dead plants and animals. They decompose complex organic substances into simple inorganic substances so that it can be used by the plants again. Abiotic components will include all the non-living components like air, water, soil, sunlight, temperature, etc. Food chain. Food chain is the series that shows the flow of food energy from one organism to the next and from next and so on. They usually start with producers, that is plants, and end with a carnivore. In a food chain, an organism gets food from one group of organisms. For example, grass is eaten by deer. Grass here is the producer and deer which consumes it is a primary consumer. Then deer is eaten by lion. So lion here is the secondary consumer. So this represents a single food chain. Then these are the samples of other food chains which are existing in environment. Which food chain basically consists of producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, and then decomposers. So these different levels in food chain are actually called the trophic levels. Then is the food web. It is a group of several interconnecting food chains. In a food web, an organism gets food from more than one group of organisms. So there are more chances of survival of organism if the organism exists in a food web, because The source of food is more than one. The organism is not dependent on a single source for food. It may get food from more than one sources. Trophic levels. Each step or level in a food chain is called trophic level. The first trophic level includes producers, second trophic level primary consumers, third trophic level secondary consumers, and fourth trophic level tertiary consumers. Since the transfer of food energy decreases at every trophic level, the number of trophic levels are limited to 4 or 5. We can't have more than 4 or 5 trophic levels in a single food chain, because at each trophic level there is decrease in energy. So finally, when we reach at the top of the food chain, we find at the top the energy received will be very, very less if the trophic level exceeds in numbers. Energy flow in trophic levels. Green plants, that is the producers, absorb about 1% of solar energy falling on the leaves and store it as food energy during photosynthesis. During the transfer of food energy from one trophic level to the next, 90% of the energy is lost to the environment and only 10% is transferred to the next trophic level. So there is a decrease in the amount of food energy which is transferred at every trophic level by 10%. And this law is called as 10% law of energy. Biological magnification. We know it is also called as biomagnification. Harmful chemicals like insecticides and pesticides are sprayed on crops to protect them from insects and pests. These pesticides are actually absorbed by plants and enter the food chain. Since these chemicals are non-biodegradable, they get accumulated at every trophic level and their concentration increases progressively with each trophic level. Since human beings occupy the highest trophic level, the concentration of these harmful chemicals is maximum in our bodies. The increase in concentration of harmful chemicals in the bodies of organisms progressively with each trophic level is called as biological magnification or biomagnification. So we can say human beings who are at the top of each trophic level, or at human beings are at the top of each food chain, we say. So they are the ones who will be receiving the maximum chemicals in their bodies. So this is called as biomagnification. Then next comes the activities which affect the environment. The human activities which majorly affect the environment are, we see there is depletion of ozone layer in the atmosphere. And this depletion of ozone layer we know is harmful, as ozone layer present in higher layer of atmosphere we know is protection against the harmful UV radiations coming from sun. So how it happens, let us see. Ozone molecule contains 3 oxygen atoms. At higher levels in the atmosphere, the UV radiation splits up these oxygen molecules into 3 oxygen atoms. These free oxygen atoms combines with oxygen molecules to form ozone. It is highly poisonous, we know it. The depletion of ozone layer is harmful, as these radiations, harmful radiations which are coming from sun, they result in cancer, skin cancer in humans. Ozone layer is also damaged by use of chemicals like chlorofluorocarbons, which are used in our refrigerators and ACs. So the use of CFCs is now being reduced to protect the ozone layer. We can say ozone layer is actually the protective umbrella for us. Here are some figures which represent how the ozone layer in the atmosphere is actually getting depleted. and is resulting in ozone hole in our atmosphere. Then next is how to manage the waste, the household waste basically, which is produced. Household waste is, you know, is called garbage. Some of the garbage is biodegradable and some is non-biodegradable. Garbage causes air, water and soil pollution, so it should be disposed of properly. Some of the methods of management of garbage disposal are by creating landfills, by recycling, production of biogas and manure from garbage, preparation of compost by making compost pits like vermicomposting, etc., incineration, then sewage treatment. These are some of the ways by which we can manage the different household waste which are produced. Here they have shown some figures indicating landfills, then recycling, preparing compost, then producing biogas and manure. So these are some of the ways in which we can manage garbage in a useful manner without affecting the environment.